Welcome to night prayer on Wednesday the 9th of September. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Lord, it is night.
The night is for stillness. Let us be still in the presence of God. It is night after a long day. What has been done has been done. What has not been done has not been done. Let it be.
The night is dark. Let our fears of the darkness of the world and of our own lives rest in you.
The night is quiet. Let the quietness of your peace enfold us, all who are dear to us, and all who have no peace.
The night heralds the dawn. Let us look to a new day, new joys, new possibilities. The Lord Almighty grant us a peaceful night and a perfect end.
Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord, the Maker of heaven and earth. Let us confess our sins to God. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you through our own fault, in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. For the sake of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, forgive us all our offences, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. May the Almighty God grant us forgiveness of all our sins and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Psalm 45, verses 11 to the end. So shall the king have pleasure in your beauty. He is your Lord, so do him honour.
The people of Tyre shall bring you gifts. The riches of the people shall seek your favour.
The king's daughter is all glorious within. Her clothing is embroidered cloth of gold.
She shall be brought to the king in raiment of needlework. After her the virgins that are her companions.
With joy and gladness shall they be brought, and enter into the palace of the king.
Instead of your fathers you shall have sons, whom you shall make princes over all the land.
I will make your name to be remembered through all generations. Therefore shall the peoples praise you for ever and ever.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever. Amen. Behold our defender, O God, and look upon the face of your anointed. Lord our God, bring your bride, your holy church, with joy to the marriage feast of heaven, and unite us with your anointed Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Our reading this evening is from St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 6. Then he looked up at his disciples and said, "Blessed are you who are poor, for yours is the kingdom of God. Blessed are you who are hungry now, for you will be filled. Blessed are you who weep now, for you will laugh. Blessed are you when people hate you, and when they exclude you, revile you, and defame you on account of the Son of Man. Rejoice on that day and leap for joy, for surely your reward is great in heaven, for that is what their ancestors did to the prophets. But woe to you who are rich, for you who have received your consolation. Woe to you who are full now, for you will be hungry. Woe to you who are laughing now, for you will mourn and weep. Woe to you when all speak well of you, for that is what their ancestors did to the false prophets." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
For you have redeemed me, O Lord, O God of truth.
Keep us, O Lord, as the apple of your eye.
Hide us under the shadow of your wings.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who at this evening hour lay in the tomb, and so hallowed the grave to be a bed of hope for all who put their trust in you, give us such sorrow for our sins which were the cause of your passion, that when our bodies lie in the dust, our souls may live with you for ever.
Amen.
Gracious God, you have called us to serve you. Grant that we may walk in your presence, your love in our hearts, your truth in our minds, your strength in our wills, until at the end of our journey we know the joy of our homecoming and your peace. Amen. We marvel at the mystery of the stars, moon and sky, sand and sea. We marvel at the mystery of the sun, twilight, high noon, dusk and dawn. Though we are mortal, we are creation's crown, flesh and bone, steel and stone. We dwell in fragile temporary shelters. Grant steadfast love, compassion, grace. Sustain us, Lord, our origin is dust. Splendor, mercy, majesty, love endure. We are but little lower than the angels. Resplendent skies, sunset, sunrise, the grandeur of creation lifts our lives. Evening darkness, morning dawn, renew our lives as you renew all time.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Have set your servant free to go in peace, as you have promised. For these eyes of mine have seen the Saviour, whom you have prepared for all the world to see, a light to enlighten the nations and the glory of your people Israel. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be for ever.
Amen.
Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace.
Amen.
The Almighty and Most Merciful Lord, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep us.
Amen.